Good win, Andrew?
Yeah, it's a great result for us, to be honest, David. We've spoken about all week after the first month of the games. We had a good start of the season and we had to continue that momentum. It was an important result for us today, because at the end of the day, Halifax are going to be there or thereabouts in the mix at the end of the year. A number of teams fight for that top four, and it was important that certainly at home that we got the result today. We work very, very hard for it in the end, but certainly a great result for us.
You had to defend a couple of sets near your own line about 6 minutes from time, which was pretty crucial, wasn't it?
Oh, absolutely crucial. It was a real test of the player's character, and I've said it before that this team this year, there's a different attitude, a different steel and resilience within it, and I think it showed signs of that today, because there were times where Halifax really caused us a lot of problems and put us under a hell of a lot of pressure. And defensively, we just managed to scramble and keep turning up for each other and did enough to, obviously just to stop the play at the end there. So, pretty pleased overall with how we've managed ourselves defensively at times. There was a couple of errors defensively we made, which I was disappointed with, that we'll address during the week. But overall, in terms of the attitude and the effort defensively, I thought it was pretty good on the whole.
There was an awful lot of drop ball in the game. The conditions certainly with that hailstorm just before the start, it must have made the ball very, very slippery. Did the players mention anything to you about it?
Brian mentioned it to me. No.
I thought it was good. Surface was good. Conditions were fine. It got a bit scrappy at times, probably for both teams. But I think London took their chances today. We didn't quite capitalise on ours.
Hendo, you must be chuffed. 4 wins from 5. Good start to the season.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, if you'd have said that to me at the start of the season, we'd have 4 from 5, I would be in. It's something we've worked really hard for in the pre-season. We wanted to get off to a good start. Obviously, we got a lot of criticism last year as a club and as a team. But like I said, it's a different club this year, it's a different team this year. And, I'm just glad that we're on the right road. But again, it's very early in the season. I am getting too carried away with it all. I'm a pretty humble person. I'll stay pretty grand with it because things can change very quickly in rugby league within a week. And I know my friend Richard Marshall sat here and, two results. But, if you look at their form last year, they started slowing the competition and just came together and clicked at the right time and smashed everyone. So, it just goes to show that, it's certainly, you don't win things at this time of the year. It's important, I guess, to pick up points, this time of the year, but it's not the be all end all. There's certainly plenty of time left. And I know Richard will certainly turn his team around and get them back to winning ways. We're no doubt about it because the style of football they play, it's quite exciting, it's entertaining. I'm sure the fans from both teams will have been entertained today with some of the football on show. For us, like I said, it's been important for us that we got off to a good start, especially coming to this new home and the fact that we are trying to build a club here. And like I said, it's a new team. I'm really, really pleased with the way we started.
Yeah. Richard, you had your chances, didn't you, today?
Yeah, we had several chances, a couple of line breaks. We looked a bit hesitant into good ball and probably didn't spend enough time down there. Certainly in the first half, the play was all with London and momentum, and they got away from us a little bit. I thought defensively we were good to keep them out because they kept throwing plays and shapes at us and we did well. But their scramble was good the last 10 minutes of the game. I think it was a 2-point ball game and we managed to give a penalty away and that hurt us on the line. And then we couldn't capitalise on our possession in good ball from there on in. It was a good contest, it was a good game. Frustrating though for me as coach.
You had a very good chance to score just before the half-time hooter when you had 2 consecutive sets of 6 inside the London 10. Did you feel that was almost a turning point, that you didn't go in ahead at half-time?
Not particularly, because we back ourselves, we're a good team. We've got good skill levels. On this occasion, they weren't good enough today. That's probably a little bit down to London's defence and resolute attitude to work hard for each other. We probably didn't. We got a bit fancy in terms of trying to tap the ball instead of doing the harder stuff. What got us through the line was just running hard and straight and putting some little plays on in and around the middle of the field. And we sort of went away from that. So a little bit of ill discipline didn't help us there towards the end.
Hendo, Wes Nagama only got one kick out of four today, and you brought Scott Levy-Barrow on to take the goals. Is that something you're going to be doing next week, or are you going to be sticking with Wes?
Oh, we'll have to address it this week, mate. Again, I'm not one to force a change, you know. If Wes isn't confident, like I said, you know, he obviously wasn't confident after not kicking so well today, and obviously Hendo grabbed the screen. You know what I mean? If he wants to hand it over, he'll hand it over. Because at the end of the day, you've got to, if the player's confident to do the job, you've got to put your trust in him. You know, because Wes, as we know, is an accomplished goal kicker. Yeah, he hasn't been informed his goal kicker this year, that's for sure. But again, like I said, if it comes a regular occurrence, then yeah, you may need to address it in the future. But at this stage, you know, I'll leave it up to him at this stage.
So that's his decision rather than
yours? Yeah, I'll leave it up to him, yeah.
Sure. And how's the heart both of you in that last 10 minutes was quite dramatic, you?
It's funny, okay. Yeah, it's funny, I was quite calm. Whereas like last week at Workington, I was the opposite, you know what I mean? It was funny when I actually felt that we were good enough to win the game. You know, I felt, you know, Richard highlighted there in the first half. I think we probably enjoyed the better of the half in the first half in terms of field position and possession. And I think we really came at it. You know, we credit Halifax, they hit us and sucker punched us with a couple of good tries. And which they've got that ability, and it's something I spoke to my players about all week, that this team can play football. They'll ask a lot of questions, obviously they'll challenge you in different ways that you don't get normally challenged by other teams. And they showed that today. And then, like I said, coming out second half, they started the second half on fire. They came out with a lot of high energy and intensity, which I knew they would after Richard's half-time team talk. And like I said, they made a couple of line breaks, and like I said, scored some tries, and all of a sudden it was kind of us sort of chasing our tails a little bit there, and we had to sort of, you know, almost weather the storm, so to speak, and try and come through it. And I just try to get that message to the players that, look, if we get some field position, we've just got to get back through the arm wrestle. Don't be frantic and get caught up and then lose your composure. Because we did, I think it was about a 10-minute spell there, and we did. You know, Leatherbow throw it in the touch, and Will Bartow kicks it out on the full. And we did, we lost our way a little bit, and we were playing with Halifax's hands for me. And then, luckily, we just calmed down, got ourselves back into the grind. And then we got a little bit of field position on the back of it. As Richard Riley said, we capitalised on those chances in that field position. And ultimately, we did enough at the end there to hang on. And defensively, like I said, we got under the pump that last 5 or 6 minutes. And we were very, very good there to hold a strong Halifax side out there.
And your Keir had a very solid game.
Yeah.
What's his situation?
He's playing.
He played 2 or 3 weeks ago, he was playing for Scholars.
Yeah.
Was that just to get rugby league minutes into him, or...?
Yeah, well, at the end of the day, you know, Keir's just had to bide his time, and, you know, I mean, he had to go on a dual edge a few weeks ago, because the team was playing well, and they got an opportunity, obviously, last week through some injury, played a good role in that game at Workington, so they kept his position for this week.
Is Ilias injured?
Sorry?
Is Ilias injured?
Ilias was injured, yes, this week, but it's not the same with Wesley.
Andrew, you mentioned you know, trying to build this home form, and you've got another home game next week. Obviously, this will help you going into that. Yeah. What's your feelings about next week?
Well, it's another challenge, isn't it? You know, Dewsbury, a bit of a baby team for us, for us. So again, yeah, they'll always come down, you know, with confidence that they can do a job. And again, it's just about us. You know, I'm not too worried about them. It's about us and about how we respond after the back of this result. Can't get too carried away, like I said, we're just going to continue to work hard. I've said it to my players, we're going to work harder than any other team in this competition if we're going to get what we want at the end of the year. And that's the mentality we're going to have this week. We're going to work hard again and make sure we come in there and do another job again next week.
Any injuries picked up today, James?
Yeah, we, Ben Kay got a head knock in the first half and we couldn't use him again. And he was in a poor state. And Scott Morrell has got a really nasty cut on his hand, and that requires plastic surgery, the doctor tells me, so pretty bad on that. But he was getting strapped up towards the end of the game, in the in goal, and then about two minutes later down at the other end scoring a try. And that's, you know, that's what you want from your captain. And you know, I feel for him in this situation that he's put all that effort in, and we haven't got the result that we wanted. So yeah, we're a little bit busted up on that, but we've got a bigger squad this year, so hopefully it won't hurt us too much.
Who are you on next week?
We play Lee.
I can see you there.
Yeah.
Andrew, any injuries coming?
Just James coming to a dead leg in the first half. He came back on, but just didn't get going again, so he pulled back off. So that was the only one for me that's at this stage.
Is Israel any nearer to
big games? Yeah, I don't think we would have played Israel this week anyway. I think it would be a week too soon. But yeah, he's probably not too far away now. He did pick up a minor hamstring strain at training during the week, so it might set him back another week now. We'll have to wait and see. But again, I can only assess him. When I feel he's ready and he's earned the right to be in the team is when he gets in the team.
Can't change a winning team.
It's hard to change a winning team, but I've done it over the last 4 weeks. You know, there's been plenty of changes over the last 4 weeks. At the end of the day, whether you're winning or losing, I pick up players based on performance, the way they're training, and also the way they're playing. So the players will know they're on their toes. And look at what Richard said, got a big squad now, got some strength and depth, and some healthy competition with places, which we didn't have last year. And that does, it keeps people on their toes. And if you're training well and you're playing well, you keep your spot. It doesn't matter if we're winning or not. You know, it's all about an individual performance. So, and at the moment, if guys are performing, that.